And our next group, Girl Scouts of the USA, has been taking care of kids on a neighborhood level since 1912. The Girl Scouts isn't just about Thin Mints and Samoas. Nearly 2 million girls and 800,000 adult volunteers are guiding this institution into the future while continuing to teach girls courage, confidence, and character. And I know I was one of them. The impact a single Girl Scout leader can make is evident in our next mentor-mentee story. Meet Ray Yan and Pooja Nagpal from the Girl Scouts of Greater Los Angeles. And thank you both for coming and joining us here for American Graduate Day. And Ray, thank you for this Girl Scout pin.
Oh, you're welcome.
I should have brought my own from home, but I'm glad you had this one for me.
That's great.
So let me start with you. You're the daughter of immigrants from Taiwan, and you joined the Girl Scouts when you were a child. And then as an adult, you became a volunteer. Why did you decide to be a volunteer and a mentor for the Girl Scouts?
I thought the Girl Scout program was a worthwhile program to join. And for $15, it's so easy to join. And my daughter was a daisy. She started, you know, in Girl Scouts. And I was the cookie mom or the treasurer and did Girl Scouts that way. And then when the girls were about 12, I became a leader and started to lead the girls through their middle school and high school years.
And Pooja and your twin sister Mira were in your troop.
Yes.
And you, your parents are also immigrants from India. You came up with the idea, I want to join the Girl Scouts, and they liked it. And you stuck with it from age 12 until you graduated from high school just this past year.
Right.
Why, a lot of other girls drop out. Why did you stick with it all these years?
It was the confidence that it instilled with me. And like the sisterhood. The sisterhood was these girls just mentoring each other, these girls empowering each other. And when I was younger, sort of, I was interested in a lot of activities that sometimes discourage girls, like martial arts, there's not many girls. Some engineering courses don't have many girls. Mm-hmm. But Mrs. Yan and all the other girls encouraged me, just find what you're passionate about and follow through with it. And that's what Girl Scouts.
Well, you know, Ray, girls like Pooja, there are so many choices of their after-school activities. There are sports. She was in marching band. She was taekwondo. You know, it's a lot of other things to do. What do you say to girls? What's your pitch to have them stay in the Girl Scouts?
Yeah, you have a choice between doing a sport or doing music and doing the arts. But Girl Scout is about service and about taking your time and helping to serve others as a volunteer and as well as a girl wanting to serve her community. And I think that's a really great cause to be in.
And you have been a leader in this whole service area. You came up with the idea of having a program for girls, teaching girls self-defense. And you've been working with girls in the Watts area of Los Angeles, in housing projects, homeless shelters. Why did you decide, and you got a black belt in the process, why did you decide to do this? What motivated you to do this particular program?
It was the same empowerment that I felt that Mrs. Yan gave to me and Girl Scouts instilled with me. It was the idea that it takes a lot of mental strength to go through whatever circumstance and challenges that you have. So I heard of stories of girls who were undergoing teen dating violence, or mm-hmm. they were fearful of going to school because the violence, mm-hmm. or just some circumstantial areas that they couldn't control. So I thought of the idea that what if they were to empower themselves through physical strength, through mental strength, and when I did, you know, these girls immediately told me their stories. They told me their passions and their dreams, and when they said the first punch and hut, whatever, they became so much more empowered. So the empowerment is a huge thing.
And it obviously made an impression on you because then you took this idea to your parents' home country of India, and you also did a self-defense program for girls there. And as a result, you got the Girl Scouts' highest honor, the Gold Award. When I see you're wearing your pin under your hair there, what did this recognition mean for you?
So the Gold Award isn't, you know, for me, it's not an award. It was just the beginning of my journey. It was creating a sustainable impact in an area that you're passionate about. And when I saw that impact, I decided to continue. At first, I started with 40 girls. And now, you know, total around the world in LA and India, it's become over 80 or 1,000 girls. So, you know, this idea of like a domino effect, her mentoring me and me mentoring mm-hmm. these girls who are the same age, some of them even older. Mentorship isn't just an age concept. It's empowering others concept.
And it's fabulous, and your story is so impressive. Ray, how do you feel about the girl you met when she was 12 years old, and now as a young woman? How has Pooja changed?
Oh, it's amazing. remember her being 12 years old and shyer than what you can believe. I mean, she just wanted to sit back and she wanted to watch. And she didn't want to do anything in front of other people. And she's now in front of thousands of people, and I'm so proud of what
it
she's
shows.
Done.
You're
amazing.
Very confident.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's very impressive. You're now a freshman at Berkeley. You're a student in electrical engineering. And so, you know, good luck to you. Congratulations on all that you've accomplished and where you're going next.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pooja and Ray. It was a real pleasure having you.
Thank you
and congratulations.
So much.